That's plastic. It's beautiful. And this monument is, I mean, so this was our box here. This was it here. So we had ground floor minus one and the first floor. And
so Daniel, in a nutshell, tell me, how did you put on those 250? Is it word of mouth, great coaching? Did you do some sort of advertising? Where did those extra
a lot of techniques? So there's
it was the CrossFit Games that got them.
The box is on that corner there. No, it was you take the passion for CrossFit and you add processes that you would in a normal business. So, for example, I mean, anybody who doesn't have a guest register at the entrance to their box is losing huge potential. A guest register is simply a sheet of paper where you got a column for name, telephone number, postcode, and the time they come in. And Tyson comes in and says, "Hey, you know, I saw you guys running outside." "Okay, cool. What's your name?" "Tyson." "Hi, I'm Daniel. Nice to meet you. Is this your first time in?" "Yeah, it's my first time. If you don't mind, you know, this is a private facility. If you don't mind, can you just stick your details down there?" "That's great. Thank you very much." Boom. "And if he decides to join or do a trial session, that's great. We've got an appointment for him. And if he doesn't, well, at least I've got his name and number. And I'll call him back in 2 days and say, 'Hey, Tyson, man, you know, thank you for your time 2 days ago. I know you had to talk to the missus. She's the one, you know, holding the reins and stuff. How about I invite you and your missus in?" And so it was just simple.
Yeah, boy, damn, you figured out Tyson quick.
So basically it's about making sure that your net is cast wide enough. So what we spoke earlier about the honeypot. Is my honeypot only for 25-year-old dudes that are taking their shirt off and looking buff and doing heavy weight and all this kind of stuff? And so you're scaring away a lot of the women, right? And you're scaring away the older people and all this kind of stuff. So how can you make your honeypot something that's going to attract
And even the other guys. I recently met this lady in Arizona, and she was like, "Oh, you do CrossFit?" I said, "Yeah." She said, "Well, I really want to do it, but my boyfriend, he gets really intimidated by really big buff dudes." And she showed me a picture of him, and he was like really big and buff.
Yeah.
She's like, "Oh, he always wants to be the biggest, strongest guy at his gym, and he's scared of CrossFit." I was like, "Wow, that's
But that's a trip." So how can you? So what are the barriers to potential athletes and members? There's loads. "I don't know if I can fit it in my schedule. I don't know if this is for me. It might be too intense.
I'm scared.
Oh my God, it's within groups. People will be watching me. I'll be uncomfortable." So how can you take those barriers away?
I don't know how to do that stuff.
Yeah. You invite them in. No questions asked. Just come in and do it, and I won't charge you anything. Or we do a comfort guarantee, which I would recommend as well for any box owner.
Comfort guarantee.
Yeah.
Okay.
So Savan, you're afraid that you're going to be the weakest in the group. You're afraid that, you know, you're going to look bad. You're afraid of being coached in front of other people. You don't know if your droopy bollocks will handle the kettlebell swing.
He's figured me out too. He knows you and me.
So Savan, listen, let's get you started, because you know you want to lose weight. You know you want to be able to play with your kids. You know you want to, you know, you want to be the man about the house. You want to go and skiing in the winter. You want to surf in the summer. Okay, no problem. So you know why you want to do this, but you want to think about it. I can understand that. Let's sign you up for the 6 on-ramp sessions. Do the 6. Your obligation is to do the 6 sessions. And then after that, if you don't want to continue, we take this, we tear it up, no questions asked.
Comfort guarantee.
Comfort guarantee. And I've never torn up one.
Money back?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. We'll
reimburse you for your
reimburse you, everything. And so worst case scenario, Savan, you've had 6 coaching sessions for free, and you've learned a fuckload about CrossFit.
Right.
And your level of fitness.
Yeah.
And it works.
And you can do that because, you know, once they step in and shake hands with all these strangers and they realize
within the first session you've got the girl at reception who knows your name and she's offering you a coffee, and then you've got the coach who comes up, "Hey man, you know, I'm Jason, nice to meet you. So this is your first session. Okay, tell me a little about yourself, you know, what activity you do." "Okay, cool, yeah, no worries. At the end of the session, how did you find that? Are you okay?" "Yeah, no." Listen, Greg says it, right? You know, that some people just won't take to CrossFit, right? But in general, I find that those are the guys who won't even do 6 sessions with there's no commitment, right? You sign everything, and if you decide to continue afterwards, that's fine. Then we'll debit you next month, and that's fine.
And that's not the client you would want anyways.
No, the guy who, after I've given you that sort of out, you've got a way out after 6 sessions, right? If you really want it. The guy who still says no, well, okay, fine.
I've never done a workout and been
go and do body pump and, you know.
Right. I've never done a workout and at the end been like, man, I wish I wouldn't have done that.
Yeah. You wish you weren't going to do it, when you're looking at the board.
Yeah, always afterwards it's like, oh yeah, yes.
Exactly. So there's certain techniques that
so you know processes. If you can get them in there moving six times and you believe in your coaches. Yep.
Yeah. And also another thing is that in the fitness industry, so I'm taking this from the stats that I knew when I worked in it, is that the most crucial period are the first 6 weeks. So if you can book these guys in for six sessions over 3 weeks, so two sessions a week or three sessions a week over 2 weeks, you're getting them in the habit, right? They're using your product. So interesting statistics, 13% of people who buy a membership in a fitness club, they never come for a workout. Not one. They buy a membership, they take the membership card, and they never come. It's in their wallet, and they're feeling not guilty. They're feeling, hey, man, I can drink a beer. I've just joined.
Wow, you know, that's a great fitness program. 13%,
right?
That's 13%, really true?
Yeah, 13%. And then there's another 13%, exactly 13%, that come for just one workout. And then either they're so fucking bored, or they're in such pain, they got such bad DOMS, that they don't come back, or they're intimidated, or they didn't enjoy it, or they thought they were going to get coached and they didn't get coached. So you've actually got 26% of people that will buy a membership in commercial gyms that don't use it. So by doing an on-ramp program with your new members, you're giving them that habit of using and consuming CrossFit.
What percentage of the members don't use the membership at CrossFit Louvre?
Not many. Not many. We've got a very
less than 5%.
We've got 1,300 members. So if you're not going to use it in Paris, if you're not going to use it, we do a freeze. So if you're going traveling, or you know, your office is moving, and you've
so you don't have any members that don't use it.
We have
because if you don't use it in a freeze, that's kind of a wash.
We have 8% on freeze at the moment.
But I don't count those as not using.
Some people fall off the wagon, but we'll call them.
Right. No Golds is going to freeze my membership because I'm, right? No Globo Gym is freezing my memberships because I'm going on vacation, right?
I don't know.
Okay.
I just think it's fair. If you're not using it, we're not coaching you. Why should we take full dues? But if you freeze, you're not using it, right? So right. If you're freezing the month of January, you're not going to say, oh, well, actually, I'm here for the first 15 days, not even for the last. Well, fair's fair, you know.
Here's what I'm saying. That business model depends on those 26% not to show up.
Yeah, oh, the global, yeah, yeah, totally.
But if you're freezing their money, that doesn't mean you're not depending on them.
And those figures are even worse on low cost, by the way, because people are just, so like 20 bucks, you're paying 20 bucks a month. Mm-hmm. Yeah, why drop out for 20 bucks? It's not even worth the hassle of going in and dropping out and filling out the form, man.
Right.
So they live off the fact that they're going to sign up 6,000 people for a small space and only have 1,000 that train.
Daniel, I got a question. Do you introduce nutrition in the on-ramp?
Yeah.
Okay, I'm so happy to hear that.
Session 2.
I was listening to you. Oh, that's awesome.